This short video is going to mention three steps by which you can identify the side of the bone. The simple rule is that you need to identify three features, 1, 2, and 3. The first feature which will help you identify the superior from inferior, another feature which will help you identify the anterior from the posterior, another feature that will help you identify the medial from the lateral. Let us use this rule to identify the side of this scapula. We know that the glenoid process, the coracoid process, this acromion process are all features on the superior side. This is obviously the inferior angle. So I identified one axis of the bone. Next, I need to identify the anterior posterior, that is my index finger. Okay. So I know that the very conspicuous, this process, okay, this process is the spinous process. It is something like a shelf that will project posteriorly from the blade-like scapula. So I know that that is posterior and this is the anterior side. So I identified the second axis. Next, I'm going to identify the third axis. The third axis, I have to look at the glenoid process. The glenoid process will be facing laterally, which will articulate with the head of the humerus. So that makes this the medial border. So again, I identified three features. The first feature, like corresponding to my thumb, superior from inferior. The next feature corresponding to my index finger, anterior from posterior. The next feature corresponding my middle finger, medial from lateral. So that helps me, that enables me to place this bone to be of the left side. This is the left sided scapula. Okay, because this is lateral, this is medial, this is superior, this is inferior, and this is anterior, this is posterior. This is a rule that you need to apply for any paired bone in your body to learn its side. Always begin learning a bone by identifying its side, because that will help you orientate your bone in your anatomical position. Thank you.